Being on the river is a really safe, comfortable, calming place for me. There's something about, you know, the sun on my skin, the grace of the water. Being out on the river is just one of the safest places that I know, and it's where I go when I need to, you know, just take a pause from everything that's happening. I feel very fortunate to have a really safe, kind, loving family unit that, you know, and that I've always been very close with, and the house on the river has always been very representative of, yeah, of the family. So I was around 20 years old, and I made a spontaneous decision to take a quarter off school and go travel. Within a couple weeks, decided, yeah, I'm gonna drop everything and go, and it was great, and it was a really powerful decision, and it was a really independent decision. And I was staying in a hostel, and it was the middle of the week, and I was alone in the hostel, and it was the person who worked there who actually used the key to get into my room that night, and he woke me up, and I really only have flashes of it. And one thing that messed with the way that I process it for a long time is that I remember asking that a condom be used, and actually going to get one that I had in my backpack, and having done that, mixed with the messages we receive about this issue, it was such a flood of self-blame. I now understand in the logical academic side of my brain, that's absolutely not the case. You know, very clearly that isn't what I wanted to happen, and that isn't what I had asked for. This was a total violation of my personal space and my safety in that situation. And the act of getting a condom was really a self-protection instinct. That was that tiny, tiny touch of self-protection instinct that was left in me in that moment. It took me years to come to terms with what had happened, and it's interesting because the next stop, literally the next day, I went and visited a close friend, and you know, thank goodness that was the next stop on my trip, because it gave me a safe place. I remember walking to the train, packing up my stuff as quickly as I could, and walking to the train feeling very hungover, feeling extremely ashamed, you know, literally carrying my head down, you know, facing down. Just needed to get out of this town. So I came back, you know, I came back to California, and I dove into school. You know, I way overdid it. I took way too many units, and I experienced a lot of depression, and I didn't know where it was coming from. I withdrew from a lot of close friends that I had. I wasn't engaging in the things that made me feel good about myself for a long time. You know, I spent a lot of time in my bedroom studying, doing schoolwork, or watching TV, anything to kind of zone out. I would say it was probably 2 years later that that I had a conversation with a close friend, and we realized we had really similar experiences. You know, we realized that we were processing it in a really similar way. We realized that the feelings we had associated to the experience were so parallel. And interestingly, you know, having shared that experience with this person and realizing that there was, you know, that there were other people who'd had that experience and who felt the way that I felt about it, was really kind of life-changing. Within a week, I researched the crisis center, the rape crisis center in the area, and she and I both signed up to become crisis line counselors. And we went through a really intensive training around talking to people who'd experienced sexual assaults and working with people who were in crisis. And that was really important for me to see and really important for me to process my own experience. And so that, you know, processing my own experience has been in stages for many years. And to this day, you know, I deal with self-blame and guilt and depression and anxiety sometimes, you know, and it's talking about it, and it's connecting with people who I know understand and who offer compassion and empathy that gets me through it. Come and stand in the river, current gentle and slow, send your troubles down water, down on that water flow. When you stand time, I thought it was because there was something wrong with me. And when I allowed myself to process, it's because, you know, I've had trauma around this, you know, it allowed me to shift my thinking a little bit. You know, this isn't my fault. This isn't something wrong with me. It's something that happened to me, and I can work with that. You know, I can recover from that. And that's really what I'm trying to do with this project. Let's tell these stories. Let's put faces and names to these stories and show the positivity and productivity and strength that can be found along these paths, you know. And that's sometimes an abstract thought for people, because it's sort of like, what do you mean positivity is associated to sexual assault? And say, well, certainly we're not talking about the experience itself, but I've had this experience and it's made me who I am today, and I'm proud of who I am today, and I'm proud of the accomplishments, and I'm proud of this project, and so in that sense, I wouldn't change it. You know, I wouldn't change it. The Powerful Voices Project has played a big role in my journey. It's allowed me to come to terms with my experiences and with the reality of the situation on a macro scale in a way that I don't think I ever would have. The project is definitely part of my healing. It's part of my surviving. It's part of my thriving. When I gathered up this little you know collection of tools for telling these stories, and there's so much power in it, and I have found such joy and enthusiasm and creativity in creating, you know, in working on this stuff, and these little tools that enable me to do that have become a really important piece of my own voice, you know, and my own expression. That's been such an incredible process of, you know, I'm in this sort of constant seeing the beautiful things mode. For me, it's about creating something strong and powerful out of something that was so disempowering and traumatic, you know, and creating something strong out of it allows me to find strength in it.